My name is Mickey Garcia, and I am an umpire, and I umpire the Cape Cod Baseball League. Before the game, you will see a lot of activity going on. It has to do with getting ready for the game, getting the field ready. While that's going on the field, and everybody's seeing that, what people don't see is what we're doing to prepare for the game ourselves. The first thing umpires do when we get to a game, we try to get there an hour and 15 minutes before the game. And we usually have around 3 to 5 dozen baseballs that we need to rub up. And what I mean by rubbing up is the baseballs are very shiny and slippery. But what we do use is mud. The mud we use to rub up the baseballs comes from New Jersey. It's the Delaware Creek, and that started back in the 1940s. This ex-baseball player found this mud that was good enough to rub on the baseball where the ball would not get too dark or too black, but it'll take the shine off and also improve the grip without damaging the baseball itself, making it too soft.
During the game, and the manager Chris is like, "Are you kidding me? Wait."
In order to rub the baseballs with the mud, we need water. But instead of using water, we've got into this little ritual where we just use our spit. Funny thing about spitting in my hand is, as a kid, my parents always told me not to spit. And being a father, I'm telling my kids not to spit. But here I am, spitting on my hand and playing with mud, actually. But I'm just really rubbing up the baseball, and it's part of my job now. Our first communication with the managers is at the home plate meeting before the game. I look at the lineups to make sure that the lineup is correct, that they do have 9 players, and if they do have a designated hitter, that there's a pitcher in the lineup card as well. The home team manager goes over the ground rules. Each field is a little bit different. Some fields have fences around the field and some fields don't. And in this particular game, there were no fences to determine what was inbound and out of bounds. And that's what he was just basically pointing out to us, just making sure that we understood where, not only that we understood, but also that the other manager and players understand what balls are in play and what balls are out of play. Before the game starts, when the catcher comes out to the plate to warm up his pitcher in the first inning, we always introduce each other. It's good to have a relationship with the catcher. I, as an umpire, stay behind the plate and watch 5 or 6 pitches from the pitcher. And the reason I do that is to see the movement on the ball. Most pitchers have different movements on the ball. Some throw faster, some throw slower, and some have different pitches. The last thing you want to do as an umpire is get back there with a batter in the box and seeing a pitch for the first time, because you might get fooled yourself. I enjoy doing the Cape Cod Baseball League because of the quality of the game, where you have the top college baseball players. I mean, the next level is professional baseball. If you're gonna do a job and you're gonna excel at it, you wanna be with the best. And this gives me an opportunity to work with the best players and the best umpires in the country. Many years ago, there were a couple of baseball players who were deaf. And in order for them to know what the call was, that's when the hand signals came along. That's not only do you get a safe or an out call, you also want to transfer the call of what the count is on the batter. So if there's 2 balls and 1 strike, we'll do 2 balls, 1 strike. If it's 3 balls and 2 strikes, we'll do the signal 3 balls and 2 strikes. This way, if for whatever reason a player didn't hear what we were saying, we give them a visual of what the count is. Oh, What I recommend to new umpires, what they recommended to me when I was starting, is to know the rules. You have to read the rule book and not memorize it, but really understand what the rules of baseball are. The second thing I will tell young players is you have to control the game, make it a safe environment, make sure that they're wearing the proper gear and using the proper equipment, and also keep a nice pace of the game going. I love baseball. I have a passion for it. I enjoy playing it, I enjoy watching it, and I try to play it as much as possible. And when I'm not playing it, I really do enjoy umpiring.